students and welcome back to this video series. This is your instructor Dhruvi Bhatt and today we would be discussing about management. We already understood what is economics and we went into great details about economics. We are here now on the second part of our subject which talks about management. Obviously starting with introduction to management, what is meant by management, is management a science or an art and how is management different from administration? Let us first start with definition of management. What is meant by management? Students, if you remember, we discussed during the definition of term economics that economics is derived from two terms, oikos and nomos, where oikos meant home but nomos meant management. So management is derived from a Greek word nomos. Let us see the technical definitions of management given by different people. The first definition was given by F.W. Taylor, which says that management is the art of knowing what you exactly want to do and getting it done by others and seeing to it that they do it in the best and the cheapest way possible. So management is in no way doing work. It is getting things done by others. As our Mary Parker Follett says, management is an art of getting things done through people. You are not a good manager if you do a very efficient work. You are a good manager if you manage a workforce and if you make sure that the people under you do work in the most effective and most efficient way. Henry Fayol gave the best definition. Management is to forecast, to plan, to organize, to command, to coordinate and control activity of others. In each of these definitions, we talked that we would be overseeing work of others. Management means, simply told, management means getting things done by others in the best and the cheapest way, in effective manner and in efficient manner. Remember these two words, because only if you bring out the output to be effective and efficient, then management is useful. Let us now understand that which are different fields where management is applicable. Exactly what different areas do you need to manage, and in an organization, what is the scope of management? The scope of management can be given fourfold. Which are different areas where management is applicable in an organization? The first area is production management. Here management needs to take care of the production in an organization. How many units are produced, at what price they are produced, and what will be the best production methodologies to use, which technology to use in production, how many workers to hire for production, what raw materials to use for production, etc. All these things will be managed under production management. Second thing which needs to be managed is marketing management. Seeking out the marketing of any department is the scope of marketing management. Here different things like advertisement for the product, building a new product in such a way that it is useful to the customer, reaching the customer in the best possible manner, may it be TV ads, may it be print media, may it be radio. Finding out the best way to reach the customers, making sure the best type of advertisements are made, making sure the sales are properly managed, all these things are under the scope of marketing management. Not to forget the third and the most important field which management explores, which is finance and accounting management in any organization. Where to invest, how much money to spend in which department, how much money to spend in production, how much money to spend in marketing, how much money to spend to gain the maximum profits or maximum benefits, where to reinvest the profits, whether to distribute the profits amongst the shareholders or not. All these things will be taken care of by the finance and accounting managers. Last but not the least, we have human resource management, personal or human resource management. This type of management would take care of people who work for them. Here, they will make sure that people work in the best possible manner to get out the best possible outcomes. So this is dealing with people. It deals with selection of the best workforce, maintaining the motivation of the workforce, maintaining the increments and decrements of the workforce, maintaining the overall performance of the workforce. This is the role of human resource management. This actually just summarizes the role of each and every type of management. Moving on, let us understand what is the nature of management. Same question again, whether management is a science or an art. Hopefully you will get the same answer again. Let us try and identify whether management is science or an art. The arguments in favor of management being science. Firstly, management can be termed as science because it has universally accepted principles. Let me tell you one of the principles of management. One of the principles of management says that if an employee works under a single boss, then his efficiency would be comparatively high. This is known as unity of command. Students, just like gravitational force is universally accepted, the principle of unity of command is also universally accepted. It is not that a person in India can work very well with two bosses and a person somewhere in Canada can work very well with only a single boss. That's not true. All the principles of management are applicable equally universally. That is why management is a science. Moreover, all the principles of management can be derived from observations and experimentations. I can easily experiment by letting a person work under two bosses and letting other person work under a single boss. We can definitely measure the efficiency out of two of them, and we can find from the observation that the person having only a single boss is working more efficiently. Thirdly, we can identify cause and effect relationship for each and everything in management. For example, if an employee is not performing well, we can identify the underlying cause for it. There is a possibility that he might be feeling that he is underpaid. There is a possibility that he might be suffering from some type of mental trauma. There is a possibility that he might not be good at that particular work. Each and every effect in management has some underlying cause. You just need to find it. Just like in science, every effect has some cause. Last but not the least, each and everything in management can be tested and validated using proper tests. You can test it time and again. You can test by giving proper increments and proper work environment to an employee. Obviously, he would work better than someone in the worst work environment. So, all the principles and all the laws of management can be tested, validated. They have a cause and effect relationship. They are derived from experimentation and they are universally accepted. That is why management is science. But students, science does teach us the theoretical forefront, but management is somewhat of an art too. Why so? Firstly, because along with theoretical knowledge, though you got your degree of management, you will still require practical knowledge to manage things perfectly. You will require practical knowledge, you will require experience of a long amount of time to make sure that you can manage people and you can manage everything, everyone properly. You will require some kind of practical knowledge and experience. That is why management is an art. Secondly, management ensures perfection through practice. Without practice, a manager could not be termed as a good manager. Over a period of time, manager improves his management practices, and that is why he becomes perfect only by practice. You could easily tell an experienced manager and a novice manager. Their salaries would also be having a vast difference. Why so? because at initial level you will make mistakes in management. How much ever you would have studied, how much ever management you know as a science, you will make mistakes, but with practice you will become perfect, and that is why management is an art. Thirdly, management does require personal skills. Not each manager achieves same type of heights or same success. Why so? There are several managers in an organization, each with a different salary. Why so? Why ain't, if management is a science and if everything could be known theoretically, then each and every manager must be similar. But that's not the case. Management requires personal skill, which changes from person to person. The skill to manage other people, the skill to manage other things differs from people to people, and that is why management is an art. Moreover, it also requires creativity, finding out creative ideas to make sure that you get the most efficient results. That is also a part of management, and that is why management is an art. Last but not the least, management is goal oriented, just like art, and that is why it is an art. It focuses towards the end goal and does everything to achieve that particular goal. That is why management is an art. All these arguments thus prove that management is also a mixture of science and art, just like economics. Having a deja vu of our first lecture, aren't you? Yes, students, management, just like economics, is a mixture of science and art. Moving forward, let us understand that why and how is management different from administration. What is meant by administration? Are administration and management same? If they are not, then what is the difference? That is our question for today. Let us check out the points of difference between management and administration. Students, first and foremost, we will define both of them. Management is an art of getting things done through others or directing their efforts towards predetermined goals. On the other hand, administration is concerned with formulation of objectives and policies for the organization. Students, here the difference is, management works upon getting things done by the people under them. On the other hand, administration focuses upon identifying the objectives of the organization, laying out the policies, laying out the rules and regulations to make sure that the management can work effectively. This is the difference between management and administration. Management basically gets things done through others, but how to get those things done effectively is devised by administration. The rules, regulations, the disciplinary policies, all these things would be given to management by the administration. So administration is something above management. Administration makes sure that management works effectively. Other point says that management is an executing function, or we can say it is a doing function. Management focuses on doing, and management focuses more on the work, while administration focuses more on thinking. It is a decision making function. It needs to decide upon several things. There is a possibility that management can help the administration in decision making, but administration is actually a decision making function, while management is an executing function or a working function. Moreover, management decides who should do it and how a particular thing will be done. But what should be done is the question of administration. What exactly is to be done? What is the goal, or what is the objective of the organization? What is the vision or mission of the organization? All these things are laid by administration. How to fulfill the vision and mission? That is the task of management. Of course, following the policies and disciplinary norms which are put forward by administration. Moving forward, the next difference is that management is a doing function because managers get work done under their effective supervision. As I already told you, administration on the other hand is a thinking function. They need to think more and lay out the objectives and plans for management to work upon. Moving on, management requires technical and human skills. Management requires more of a technical skill because management is very near to workers and they need to know the technical know-hows of whatever work they are managing. On the other hand, they also require human skills because they have to deal with humans on a daily basis. But administration, on the other hand, would require conceptual and human skills. Human skills are of course required because even the administrators need to deal with a great deal of people. Though people will be different, management would be dealing with workers while administrators would be dealing with other companies, other officials, maybe government, etc. Though people would be different, but both of these deal with a huge lot of people, and that is why human skills are required by both. But management needs technical skills while administration needs conceptual skills. Conceptual skills are thinking skills, decision making skills, making sure that they have a perfect knowledge of administration at hand and making the correct decisions. That is their major role, and that is why administration must be very good in conceptual skills. Management is generally carried out by the middle level and low level managers. It is the task assigned to middle level and low level managers who will in turn be managing the workers. On the other hand, administration is taken care of by the top level or the owners of the organization. Moving forward, management is carried out only in organizations whose goal is profit making. As we have discussed, management is goal oriented. What will be the goal of any organization? Obviously, profit making in one or the other manner. That is what businesses are for. So, management is a dire requirement and is found in profit making organizations, but not present in non-for-profit organizations. Administration, on the other hand, is present in all types of organizations, whether it be profit organizations, whether it be non-profit organizations, whether it be NGO, whether it be government organizations. Each and every organization requires administration, while management is taken care of only in profit organizations. Management here is influenced by the thoughts, opinions, and ideas of the manager. Values of these managers, their personal skills will be influencing the management strategies. Administration, on the other hand, will be influenced by external environment, by thoughts and opinions or policies of government, by the thoughts and opinions of the competitors of the organization. All the external factors would be affecting administration, while management is dealing with only the internal factors of the organization. Last but not the least, management constitutes of the employees of the organization or the managers of the organization, while administration is resembled by the owners of the organization, who can be the shareholders of the organization, who can be the directors of the organizations, etc. Everyone who is on the top level of management would be accounting for administration. That was all about the difference between management and administration, and that was all about today's lecture. Thank you so much for such patiently listening to me. This is Dhruv signing off. Until next time. Bye-bye.